for cantilever sheet pie okay, that penetrate in the clay. Okay, so in this case, okay, that means below the dash line. Okay, if it is clay, okay, that means we will use the undrained condition. Okay, to derive the equation. Okay, we will have the gamma saturate and for the C. Okay, or we use Cu. Okay, then for the upper soil, okay, it's still sand. Okay, then we have gamma and phi value. Okay, C equal to zero. Okay, and below the groundwater level, it will be gamma saturate and phi. Okay, C also equal to zero. Okay, mean in this case, okay, the soil, okay, is different, okay, at the dash line. Okay, above the dash line, it is sand. Below the dash line, it is clay. Okay, then for the clay, okay, when phi equal to zero, okay, then Ka and Kp, okay, equal to one. Okay, so it will be the same. Will equal to one. Okay, only for the sand, okay, with the phi value, we will get the Ka of the soil one. Okay, that means for sand. Okay, the same. Okay, above the dash line, okay, we will have only active pressure, and with this Ka, okay, with the phi value of the soil, then we will get P1 as the same, okay, Ka multiplied with gamma and 1. For the P2, okay, it will be Ka multiplied with gamma L1 plus gamma dot L2. Okay, the same. This problem also with groundwater level is the same in the left hand side and the right hand side. Okay, but below the dash line, okay, because the soil is shown to be clay, okay, with Ka equal to Kp equal to 1. Okay, but we have C, okay, that means we will have the term 2C square root Ka or Kp. Okay, then in this case, okay, just below the dash line, okay, it will be gamma L1 plus gamma dot L2. Okay, actually should be multiplied with the Ka, but because equal to 1, and then minus with 2C or 2Cu, okay, because the Ka is also equal to 1, then no need to put the square root Ka. Okay, so you get Pa equal to gamma L1 plus gamma dot L2 plus gamma saturate sat minus L1 minus L2. At this point, okay, but at the any sat, okay, that means below the form sat from the groundwater ground surface, okay, then from at this point, okay, then you will get the Ka, okay, with the sat value, okay, with this equation. Okay, actually it should be multiplied with Ka, okay, equal to 1. Okay, and 2C square root Ka also equal to 1. Okay, similarly, for the passive pressure, Pp, from the left from left to right. Okay, so that means in this case, okay, then we will get the surface will be gamma, gamma z, okay, multiply with z, okay, minus L1 minus L2, and plus 2c. That means gamma saturated multiply with Z minus L1 minus L2, okay, plus 2C, okay, because it is undrained. That means we check the water, okay, together, okay, then we use gamma saturated in the clay. And when we find the net pressure, okay, that means PA minus PP. Okay, that means use this term. Okay, then minus with this. Okay, that means this term you neglect. So we will get gamma L1 plus gamma dash L2 minus 2c and also minus again 2c. Okay, then we find because it the direction of the pressure, okay, will be in the opposite. Okay, then we get 4c minus gamma L1 plus gamma dash L2. Okay, this if we keep equal to P6, okay, and we can see that for the P6, okay, is no Z, okay, that means the value is constant, okay, not increasing with depth. Okay, that means if we draw the pressure diagram, okay, this will be continue as like this. Okay, if the pressure not changing, okay, then we will get P6 is constant up to the end of the C-pipe. Okay, but you know that when the passive occur until the C-pipe is moved in the opposite way, okay, then it will change from passive to be active, from active to be passive. Okay, then again, if this become passive, we have to find PP, and this side become active, that means it will be PA. Okay, at the end or the bottom of the sheet pipe, okay, the passive pressure, okay, from right to left, okay, that means this way. Okay, it will be gamma L1 plus gamma dash L2 plus gamma saturated D. Okay, actually it is this term. Okay, but Z minus L1 plus minus L2 we use as the D value. Okay, plus 2C. Okay, and for PA, okay, it will be gamma saturated D. Okay, minus 2C. Okay, then use PP minus PA. Okay, that means this term minus this term. Okay, then this. Okay, plus 2C. And then minus with minus, then we get plus. Okay, then we get 4C plus gamma L1 plus gamma dash L4. Okay, this will be P7. Okay, and again, actually P7 is not increasing with depth, isn't it? But in this case, because we substitute with the D at the end already. So we will get the stress distribution. Okay, like this. Okay, so and then find the summation fx equal to 0 and summation moment equal to 0 okay. For summation fx or summation fh okay. We will find the pressure diagram okay. That means this one okay. That means it is the force P1 okay. So this stress diagram will not change okay, with any penetration depth that changing okay, then we can find okay, so for P1 and then minus okay, because we didn't know this L3 okay, then we minus with total with this term okay, that means P6 multiplied with D okay, and then plus with this area. Okay, so this triangle. Okay, in order to balance this area. Okay, for this triangle, it will be 0.5 multiplied with L4 multiplied with P6 plus P7. Isn't it? Okay, for this area. Then substitute the P6 okay, this one okay, 4C minus gamma L1 plus gamma dot L2 okay, this means P6 okay, this term and multiply with D okay, for the rectangular area. Okay, and the area means the triangle. Okay, 0.5 L4 okay, multiply with P6. Okay, this term. Okay, and plus P7. Okay, equal to 0. Okay, so with this equation, okay, we have D and L4 that we don't know the value. Okay, then we find the L4 in terms of D. Okay, and we will use this to substitute when we make the summation of the moment. Okay, then L4 okay, will be D multiplied with 4C minus gamma dot gamma L1 plus gamma dot L2 okay, minus P1 divided by 4C. Okay, that means this one is take it like this. Okay, minus and plus. Okay, 4C and this another 4C will be 8C. Something like this okay, and then check with this okay, so we can find L4 in terms of D okay, then find the check the moment okay, so with summation moment equal to 0 okay, for the P that P1, okay, moment arm will be D plus Z bar up, Z1. Okay, this. And for the second area, okay, this P6 multiply with D, okay, then multiply with D over 2. Okay, so we get this one. And plus, and this one, okay, as, okay, this, minus and plus, okay, then we get 0.5 L4 multiplied with 8C, okay, like this. Okay, and then multiply with L4 over 3, okay, that means one third of the L4 equal to 0. Okay, so again, we have this L4, K, Okay, Andy, that we didn't know. Okay, but we already known alpha in terms of D. Okay, then substitute this alpha. Okay, in the equation. Okay, then we can get D square. Okay, multiply with 4C minus gamma L1 plus gamma dash L2. Okay, and then minus 2D P1. Okay, minus with 2P1 multiply with P1 plus 12C Z1 bar. Okay, divided by gamma L1 plus gamma dash L2 plus 2C. Okay, equal to 0. Okay. And then solve the equation, we will get the D value. Okay, and with this D, okay, we call as a theoretical. Okay, in practical, we will increase, okay, just increase the factor of safety. Okay, about 1.4 to 1.6. Okay, that means increase about 40 to 60%. Okay, for the penetration depth, theoretical. Okay, then find the maximum bending moment. Okay, the maximum bending moment will occur in between L1 plus L2. Okay, and L1 plus L2 plus L3. Okay, we didn't know the L3, okay, but the shear becomes zero at the point that P1 minus P6 multiply with Z. That with this area. Okay, with P minus with this area until it becomes zero. Then we get Z that equal to P1 divided by P6. Then M max equal to P1 multiplied with Z dash plus Z1 bar minus P6 Z dash square divided by 2. And knowing the maximum bending moment, we can determine the section modulus of the shear part, okay, as before. Okay, let's see the example 3. Okay, if the equation is 5.5 meter penetrated in the clay layer, okay, as shown in the figure, find the penetration depth of the sheet pi and minimum section modulus. Okay, like this. Okay, if the equation depth is 5.5, okay, 2 meter above the groundwater level and 3.5 meter below the groundwater level. Okay, then the sand we have gamma is 15 phi is 32, gamma saturate is 19 and phi also 32. Okay, for the clay, okay, gamma saturate is 19 and C is 40 kPa. Okay, and V equal to 0. Okay, then find the active pressure first. Okay, Ka, 10 square of 45 minus 32 divided by 2. Okay, 0.307. And then find the P1. Gamma L1 Ka, okay, 9.21. P2, okay, 15 multiplied with 2 plus gamma dash 19 minus 9.81 multiplied with 3.5 multiplied with 0.307, okay, 19.08. Okay, then we can get the P. Okay, so in this case, three area. Area 1, area 2, area 3. For the area 1, Okay, 0.5 multiply with P1 multiply with 2 meter. Okay, for the area 2. Okay, so 3.5 multiply with P1. Okay, for the area 3. Okay, 0.5 minus, multiply with 3.5 multiply with P2 minus P1. Okay, so 3 area. Then substitute here the value for 3 area. And then we get 58.72. Okay, this for the force P. Okay, kilonewton per meter length of the sheet pipe. And then take the moment about point E. Okay, to find the position of the force P. Okay, for the area 1, okay, check at point E, that means it will be 3.5 plus 1 third of 2 meter. Okay, for the area 2, okay, this will be half of 3.5. For the area 3, this will be 1 third of 3.5. Okay, then moment arm of each area. Okay, then we find the set bar is about 1.957 meter from the point E. Okay, then we can substitute in the equation directly. Okay, or we already know. Okay, B square multiply with 4C minus gamma L1 plus gamma dash L2 minus 2D P minus P multiply with P plus 12C Z bar divided by gamma L1 plus gamma dash L2 plus 2C equal to 0. Okay, then we get about 2.3 meter. This is for the theoretical depth. Okay, then we increase about 50% and multiply with 1.5. Okay, we get 3.45. Okay, then in practical, maybe we will use 3.5 meter. Okay. And the excavation depth is 5.5. Okay, that means total length of the sheet pipe that we need will be about 9 meter. Like this. Okay, then find set that. Okay, P divided by 4C minus gamma L1 plus gamma dash L2. Okay, just 0.406. Okay, substitute to find this Mmax. Okay, then we get Mmax 127.42 kilonewton meter per meter length. And then section modulus will be Mmax divided by sigma allowable. Okay, flexural strength. Okay, 172 multiplied with 10 power 3. Okay, then we get 0.741 multiplied with 10 power minus 3. Okay, cubic meter per meter. Okay, then if we want to use the sheet pipe, okay, with U shape like this. Okay, this is the typical section that with this U shape. Okay, we have many level of the section modulus. Okay, that means in this case, okay, the unit of the section modulus is cubic meter per meter length. Okay, but the value that we get is cubic meter. Okay, then we should change the unit to be cubic centimeter. Okay, that means from cubic meter to be cubic centimeter, we just multiply with 10 power 6. Okay, then another 10 power 3. Okay, so we will get about 741 cubic centimeter per meter length. Okay, then so we can use at the smallest size. Okay, is enough. Okay, so the friction modulus is 874 with larger than 741. Okay, that we need. Okay, so this is the manufacturer. That means we have about three company that have this sheet pie section. And like in case of the incense, okay, example 2, okay, we get the section modulus 1.22, okay, multiply with 10 power minus 3, okay, in cubic centimeter, it will be 1,220, okay, cubic centimeter per meter length. Okay, then we can select, okay, like this one is enough. Okay, that means for 1,300, okay, section modulus, okay, either depend on the manufacturer that you can select. Is for the cantilever sheet pie system. Okay, either it is pinned into sand or into clay. Okay, but actually, no limit with the soil. Okay, because if you understand and you can draw the certain distribution, okay, we can use the pressure balance, okay, and then find the summation of the stress distribution and use the summation Fx and summation moment equal to zero. Okay, then you can find the penetration depth and also the maximum moment, okay, and find the section modulus, and then you can design the sheet pie.